subscribe my channel. P. Sarala. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson.
In today's class, we learn about the ventricles of the brain. So, ventricles means the hollow cavities which are present in the brain are known as ventricles. So, these ventricles are filled with the cerebrospinal fluid. So, these are the ventricles. So, there are four ventricles present in human brain. So, two lateral ventricles which are present in the cerebral hemispheres. These two are the lateral ventricles which are present in the cerebral hemisphere. So, third ventricle is known as diacele, which is present in the diencephalon. So, this is the third ventricle which is present in the diencephalon, which is also known as diacele. The lateral ventricles are also known as paracele. So, the lateral ventricles are connected with the diacele by an opening. So, this is the opening which is known as interventricular foramen or foramen of Monroe. So, this is the paracele and this is the diacele. So, into the diacele, paraceles opens by a individual. So, this one enters through this and this one enters like this. So, total two interventricular foramen are present. So, the third ventricle opens into the fourth ventricle, which is present in the medulla region. So, this is the medulla region. So, the fourth ventricle here, that is known as
myelocele.
So, this is the third ventricle or diacele is connected to the fourth ventricle or myelocele by a small canal, which is known as cerebral aqueduct or aqueduct of Sylvius or iter. Simply, it is known as iter or cerebral aqueduct or aqueduct of Sylvius. You have to remember all the alternate names because in the examination they may ask any of the name. Okay, so the fourth ventricle opens into the central canal of the spinal cord. So this is the spinal cord. So this is the central canal. So the fourth ventricle continues into the central canal of the spinal cord. So all these four ventricles are filled with a special fluid which is known as cerebrospinal fluid. So this fluid is formed by the epithelial lining of these ventricles. So these ventricles are lined by epithelium, special epithelium, which is known as ependymal cells, and these cells secrete the cerebrospinal fluid, and this fluid is filtered 4 times a day because it has to remove all the waste and metabolites and toxins which are present in the brain and are collected by cerebrospinal fluid, and they remove the waste and toxins into the blood vascular system. So cerebrospinal fluid is filtered from the two choroid plexus, anterior choroid plexus which is present in the thalamic region and the posterior choroid plexus which is present in the medulla region. So the important function of choroid plexus is it is useful for the formation of cerebrospinal fluid and also for the removal of the waste and toxins present in the cerebrospinal fluid. So this cerebrospinal fluid present in the ventricle and also subarachnoid space. So while we are learning about the meninges, subarachnoid space is present, that also contains cerebrospinal fluid. So that fluid protects the brain from sudden jerks and shocks during the trauma. I hope you understand.